For this one, sold out in a matter of seconds, some for as much as $1 million. There's a massive interest in Formula One in the United States, so it's no surprise we have a third race in America. Welcome to the Las Vegas Grand Prix. Well, tonight we go racing around the bright lights of Las Vegas, 3.8 miles under the Nevada night sky and thousands of neon lights. There are landmarks everywhere you look, punctuating the 17 corners and two DRS zones. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. And Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Fernando Alonso, Norris, Perez, Oscar Piastri, Sainz, Russell, Stroll, Hamilton, Gasly, Hülkenberg, Albon, Magnussen, Sargent, Ocon, Joe, Ricciardo, Tsunoda, and Valtteri Bottas begins the race from the back of the grid. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
race. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 9.6 seconds. Fantastic, amazing, you deserved that race win. Well done, mate.
And as they take the checkered flag, the fans go wild. They broke the bank in Las Vegas. The strip has been conquered. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today, but what set them apart from the rest?
I think we'll chalk this one up to a deft touch on the brake pedal. That's allowed them to challenge down the inside into the braking zones, and ultimately, if you do that often enough, you end up winning the race. It was great to watch as well, though, wasn't it? Forget strategy, forget tyre management. Who doesn't love a good old-fashioned scrap?
Here comes your top three, making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One.